Hello and welcome to Unit 16.2 of Medlock Method Basic Chinese. I'm Michael. 你好。
你好，我是邱老师。
What are we doing in 16.2, 邱老师?
We have more telephone conversation and we learn how to leave messages.
Okay, so we get on with it then.
Yep. Listen, please.
请问王先生在吗？
对不起，他不在位子上。您哪位？
我是陈晓东。
您要不要留话？
请问王先生在吗？
对不起，他不在位子上。您哪位？
我是陈晓东。
您要不要留话？ OK, 请问王先生在吗？ Very easy to say. 对不起，他不在位子上。位子。Wait means seat, so he's not at his seat. That's Chinese way to do it. But in English, you would say he is not at his desk. Yeah. But Chinese, you say he is not at his seat. Wait, Shang. 您哪位? So who are you? 您哪位? Yeah, that's, 哪位 is more higher register than 您哪儿? 哪位?
And notice the way, is it the same way in for high register person?
Yeah.
And seat?
Yeah, seat.So, 您哪位是 which seat are you?
Ah, okay. So, probably in times gone by, only the very important people had seats.
Yeah, so when I ask you, 您哪位, it means that I think you are important, you have a seat.
Posh Chinese, yes.
Yes, okay. 您哪位? Okay, who are you? 哪位? 我是陈晓东,您要不要留话? I think it's very easy, 留话, to leave.Words. So do you want to leave words? Listen and repeat, please.
请问王先生在吗？
对不起，他不在位子上。您哪位？
我是陈晓东。
您要不要留话？
请问王先生在吗？
对不起，他不在位子上。您哪位？
我是陈晓东。
您要不要留话 ？Okay, let's move on to next slide. Listen, please.
好，请您告诉他，我明天上午十点再给他打电话。请他别走开，麻烦您了。好，请您告诉他，我明天上午十点再给他打电话。请他别走开，麻烦您了。
OK, 好，请您告诉他。That's a very typical way to leave a message. 请您告诉他。Or you can say, 麻烦您告诉他，我明天上午十点。Tomorrow, 10 o'clock. The time phrase goes after subject. Of course, you can go before subject as well. 明天上午十点，我 is also okay. 再给他打电话 again. Give him a call. Give him a call. 十点再给他打电话。再 means again. Okay.
Can I use it if I'm asking for another of something?
Yeah, yeah.Remember, 再来一杯啤酒。
Of course, yes, another glass of beer.
Yeah, 再来一碗面。
Mm-hmm.
再说一次。I know we haven't learned 一次。一次 means one time. 再说一次 means say it again. 再说一次。Okay, let's come back to here. 请他别走开。Okay, please ask him. 请 someone to do something. Let's ask someone to do something. 请他别Don't. 走开 means to go away. Remember, 走, so it's to walk. And 开 means
to drive. Open.
Open or drive. Okay, to start something. So to walk away, it means.
If someone is bothering us, if someone is giving us 麻烦, can we tell them to 走开?
Yeah. Okay, you can tell someone to 走开. Okay. And 麻烦您了.
Why the 了?
usually have indication that something has happened. So I have troubled you already. I have told you to do this and that. Mm-hmm. So I have troubled you.
So if I said 麻烦您 at the beginning, I wouldn't have to put 了.
That's right. For example, here you can say 麻烦您告诉他. So I trouble you. And I haven't told you what I'm going to trouble you about.
Okay, when then, you finish troubling, you add a 了.
That's right. Okay. Okay. I'd like to introduce another word. 见面. 见面. You know, 见, 再见.
Mm-hmm.
见 means to see. And 面
Oh,
is,
that was face, wasn't it?
That's
we had
right.
it in one of the
so
previous classes.
Yeah, meet up for Chinese people, you have to see the face.
Yeah, well, we meet face to face, so it's not that hard a concept
that's
for
right.
us to understand.
So, I'm going to give a quiz. Could you please tell him we meet up tomorrow?
请你告诉他我们明天见面。
That's right. 请你告诉他我们明天见面。And can you make it a little bit more challenging here? Could you tell him tomorrow at 10 o'clock we meet up? We meet at 10 o'clock tomorrow.
请你告诉他我们明天十点见面。
Good. 请你告诉他我们明天十点见面。Okay, listen and repeat, please.
好,请您告诉他。我明天上午十点再给他打电话。请他别走开。麻烦您了。好,请您告诉他。我明天上午十点再给他打电话。请他别走开。麻烦您了。
Okay, listen please. 不客气，我一定告诉他。不客气，我一定告诉他。Okay, yeah. 不客气。You're welcome. When someone says thank you to you,、
mm-hmm.
and you say,
Don't stand on ceremony.
Yes.、Mm-hmm.And 我一定告诉他 I definitely would tell him.
That seems a little odd to us because...
Is it?
Yeah, why would you definitely tell him?
Well, if here in Chinese, it means I promise I will do it.
Ah, this is a promise.
Yeah,、mm-hmm. I promise that I will do it.
I'll make sure he gets that message.
That's
really、
right.
what you're trying to say.
That's right. Okay,、mm-hmm. so I make sure I tell him. Okay, 我一定告诉他 Listen and repeat, please. 不客气。我一定告诉他。不客气。我一定告诉他。Okay, let's move on to the next one. But we do need more exercise.
Absolutely. So let's、yeah. get a bit of practice now.
Yeah, how to leave messages.
Tell me, please tell him that I'll call him again at 4 this afternoon.
At 4 this afternoon is...今天下午四点 Please tell him I'll call again. Would be 请告诉他我再给他打电话
Shall I repeat that again?
Yes, please.
So please tell him I'll call him again at 4 this afternoon.
So give the tip. The time goes behind the subject here. Yeah?请告诉他我今天下午四点再给他打电话。
How do you think you say from one time to another time in Chinese? So from 3 to 5, for example.
Okay, in Chinese it would be from and get to somewhere, arrive somewhere.
That's 到。
Yeah, 到。Okay, so it would be...从三点到五点，从到 ，okay, from time point to another time point.
Okay, using this pattern, tell me. He's not in the office from 3 to 5.
他从三点到五点不在办公室。
Tell me, in that case, I'll call him again at 2.
那我两点再给他打电话。
Please tell him that I'd like to meet up with him.
请告诉他我想和他见面。
Please ask him if we can meet up tomorrow.
请你问他我们明天能不能见面。
Tell me.The bank that's next to the office.
In Chinese, it's the bank which is next to the office. Yeah. So it would be the. 在办公室旁边的银行。
Okay, we're going to put these two sentences together now. Please ask him if we can meet up at the bank next to the office tomorrow.
Okay, I give the hint. The location, yeah, is going to be in front of the action. 见面。请你问他，我们明天能不能在办公室旁边的银行见面？ It's a long sentence. I repeat this again.请你问他我们明天能不能在办公室旁边的银行见面。
Okay, let's move on to the next slide and we'll be doing a different dialogue.
Listen, please. 喂？
喂，找谁？
请问王先生在吗？
谁呀？
喂？
喂，找谁？
请问王先生在吗？
谁呀？
okay. 喂？喂，找谁？ So who are you after? 请问王先生在吗？谁呀？ Who? 谁呀？ Who? Who are you after? Okay.
That's the implication that you've never heard of this person.
Yeah, so, I cannot hear you properly. Okay, listen and repeat, please. 喂？
喂，找谁？
请问王先生在吗？
谁呀？
喂？
喂，找谁？
请问王先生在吗？
谁呀？
Okay, let's move on to the next slide. Listen, please. 我找王先生，我是他女儿。
这儿没有王先生，你打错了。
我找王先生，我是他女儿。
这儿没有王先生，你打错了。
我找王先生 ，I'm looking for, I'm after 王先生。我是他女儿，女 is girl and 儿 means child, yeah. So girl child is daughter. And son would be 儿子，儿子。这 here 没有王先生。We usually have location in front. 这 here.
That's the opposite way around to English. English is there isn't any Mr. Wang,
Wang here.
Here.
But here there aren't Mr. Wang. Okay, there isn't Mr. Wang. Okay, 这没有王先生。你打错电话了，打错 call.Wrongly. 错 remember 错、不错错错 means mistake. 打错 means you call a mistake.
So if I made the mistake and I was saying sorry, I would say, oh, 对不起我打错了。
对我打错了。Oh, you can say 我打错电话了。打错电话了。Listen and repeat, please. 我找王先生。我是他女儿。
这儿没有王先生。你打错了。
我找王先生，我是他女儿。
这儿没有王先生，你打错了。
Okay, let's move on to the next slide. Listen, please. 怎么会呢？怎么电话号码会是错的呢？怎么会呢？怎么电话号码会是错的呢？怎么会呢？ Means, how can that be? How can that be? Okay, 怎么会呢？会 means can, means will. Here means, how can that be? Can.And 会 also means ability, some kind of ability you have to learn. 会、mm-hmm. For example, 我会开车 I can drive, learn how to drive.
你会讲英语
Yes, 我会讲英语 And that 会 is I learn the language, 英语 English, 会怎么电话号码 How come a telephone number can be 错的会是错的错的We have learned 错 okay, mistake. 是错的 is a mistake.、
Mm-hmm.
Okay. 怎么电话号码会是错的 Listen and repeat, please. 怎么会呢怎么电话号码会是错的呢怎么会呢怎么电话号码会是错的呢
I think we need a little bit of practice on these different kinds of can, because in English, can means can, but in Chinese, there are different kinds of can.
Okay, you mean can as 会, ability to, you have to learn, and 能, 能 is the ability you're
physically able to,
or the circumstances make、mm-hmm. you can do it, you're able to do it, okay.
Okay, first,I want to remind you of how to say language.
Colloquially,、mm-hmm. yeah. There will be like a 流话,、
mm-hmm.
话
And so, for example, when you're talking about Chinese, normally you don't normally say 中文, you would say 普通话
普通话 So, 话 and 普通话 So, 话 is a spoken language.
Ask me, can you speak Spanish?
你会不会说西班牙话？西班牙话 ，you stick the country right in front of 话 and make it the language of this country.、
Mm-hmm.
So it's a language of Spain.
Tell me, no.
不会。
Ask me, how many languages can you speak?
你会说几国话 ？Okay.几国话 means how many country languages?
How many country speaks?
That's right. How many country speaks?
Tell me English, French, and Chinese. This time use 语.
English, 法语, 还有汉语.
Ask me, can you drive?
Driving the ability is acquired.你会开车吗?
Tell me, of course.
当然会。
Ask me, can you drive tomorrow?
And now, Mr. Are you able to? The circumstances, yeah. 你明天能不能开车?
Tell me, sorry, no. My wife wants to use the car.
对不起，不能，我太太要用车。对不起，不能，我太太要用车。
Okay, now we want to look at another use of 会 to say that you really can do something, meaning you're very good at it.
And then you say 很会。
Tell me, he's very good at cooking, but he doesn't have time today. He can't cook for us.
So he's good at cooking is 他很会做饭。 他很会做饭，不过今天他没空，不能给我们做饭。Cook for us is 给我们做饭 is like 给我们打电话。Similar sentence pattern, 给我们做饭 is cook for us. So cook to give that to us. I repeat the sentence again. 他很会做饭，不过今天他没空，不能给我们做饭。
Tell me, I can't speak English.
我不会说英语。
Ask me, can you help me make a phone call?
你能不能帮我打电话？
And put those together. I can't speak English. Can you help me make a phone call?
我不会说英语。你能不能帮我打电话? Okay, good. Let's move on to next slide. Listen, please.
你打几号?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
打错了。你打几号?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
打错了。
Okay, here, 打, 打 literally means to hit, and 打电话, 你打几号, you don't have to say 你打电话几号, you just use 打, the verb.
So you hit which numbers?
That's right, 你打几号, 一二三四五六, as we said before, you hear 幺二三四五六, you hear 幺 a lot, 打错了, that's wrong number, so you have wrong number, you say, oh, 对不起, 打错了, okay,Listen and repeat, please.
你打几号?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
打错了。你打几号?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
打错了。
Okay, it's wrap up time.
Yeah, then we'll try to build up a conversation.Here on the telephone, and you're going to be calling a hotel. Tell me, hello, Warbing Hotel.
喂，国宾饭店，您好。Okay, don't forget 您好, being polite.
Ask me, can you speak English?
您会不会说英语？
Tell me yes, but not very well.
会可是不太好。
Tell me, in that case, I'll speak Chinese.
那我说汉语好了。Of course, here you can say, 那我说普通话好了。
Ask me, can I leave a message?
我可不可以留话?
Say yes. For whom? Which room?
可以给哪位几号房?
Tell me, 3010, Miss Lee.
给3010房。李小姐, or 给3010房,李小姐。
Please tell her, I'll wait for her in the lobby at 3 p.m.
请告诉她我下午三点在大厅等她。I repeat that again. 请告诉她我下午三点在大厅等他。
Right, I think you've got a fair level of competence and hopefully confidence on the telephone now. So it's time for us to say 再见.
再见. Have fun.